Oh God, we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Oh, Jesus.
Free of everything that's hindering. The boldness and the confidence in praying and pouring out the hearts of the Spirit is the same boldness that we need to be able to win the loss of the children and get filled with the Holy Spirit. And that's everybody. Just come down just for a few minutes and we all join together. We want to pray for Holy Ghost boldness. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Begin in prayer, Alva. Amen. Pray to the Spirit. Just want to pray. Amen. Crying out mightily. Everybody just said crying out mightily in the Spirit. That's the thing that frees us and releases us and gives us boldness. Amen. To go on and do the works of the Lord. Hallelujah. We can't hold back. We can't be timid and weak kneed and keep everything toned down. We just got to get a full release of our spirit so that we can, amen, receive the anointing needed in order for the gifts of the Spirit to work and the power of God to be released in our lives individually. So we want everybody to just cry out mightily in the Spirit. In this cry out mightily. In the Spirit.
Lord, work your will and do it.
in Jesus' name. The name above every name. Healer is in that name. Salvation is in no other. No other name given unto men whereby we might be saved. Save in the name of Jesus. We lift that name this morning. Hallelujah. We exalt that name. Hey, hallelujah. We come to the Mahashataya. Will we demand done in that name? Hallelujah. Lord, we say hallelujah. You will do it. Whatever we ask for, Father, in that name. We say the Father will do it. Lord, we thank you for that name.
All the men, come up here. We're going to surround him. Come on here. Oh, Father God, in the name of Jesus, you are all-knowing God. You know exactly what's going on with this young man, Father God. You know his needs. You know his wants. You know and you have a plan for his life, Father God. He may not be aware of, Father God, so we ask you right now by laying hands on him to open up his eyes that he may see. Build that hedge around me, Father God, that he may walk in a peace that surpasses all understanding. Knowing that it is you that is guiding him. gave me ears that are sensitive, not to that loud voice, not to the flesh, Father God, but to that still small voice that comes from your Holy Spirit, Father God. Touch this young man. Touch him, Lord. Amen. And I command every demon that's trying to bind him, I bind that demon in the name of Jesus. Loose him in the name of Jesus. Loose him. Come out of him right now, Father God. And we're going to fill him with your love, Father God. Fill him with your love, Father God. Let it just shine on him that he affects his neighborhood, his whole family, Father God. Woman has sent him into the
thank you for the flow of the Holy Ghost in this young man, Lord God. Thank you for a greater love, Lord God. A love that covers a multitude of sin, a love that covers a multitude of sin, a love that conquers all things. Oh, thank you for the love of God shed abroad in this heart, Lord God. Oh, thank you for grace. And fully equipped to accomplish your perfect will in this life, Lord God. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you for the anointing that's filling any and every void that he may have right now, Lord God. Complete surrender is all to you, Lord God. We just thank you, Lord God. We thank you for a new love. We thank you for a greater compassion. Hallelujah, Lord God. Oh, thank you that it was endowed upon them, Heavenly Father, the spirit of wisdom and the spirit of revelation and the knowledge of you, Lord God. The eyes of his understanding that they be enlightened, Heavenly Father. For that he know his call, Heavenly Father, which is in Christ Jesus. And the riches of his glory, which is his inheritance, Heavenly Father. We thank you for the mighty power of Christ, Heavenly Father, that's working in him, Heavenly Father, to accomplish God's perfect will for his life, Lord God. We just thank you for him, Lord God. A wonderful asset for the kingdom of God, Lord God. Hallelujah. Continue to send laborers across this path that will continue to strengthen them, Lord God. Hallelujah for your word. Hallelujah for the preacher. Hallelujah for friends, new friends, Heavenly Father, that you're bringing into his life, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for a new passion for your word. Thank you for a new passion for Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you that he's emotionally attached to the will of God. Hallelujah. That his intellect is based upon your laws. That your promises, Heavenly Father, endows his imagination. Allow him to be fully consumed with your word, Lord God. Fully consumed with the love of God, Lord. Oh, we give you glory, honor, and praise for the asset that this young man is to your kingdom, Lord God. We thank you for him. We give you glory, honor, and praise for him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, it's a new day. It's a new day. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the full manifestation of your glory operating in and through us, Lord God. Oh, to affect change in the world. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Glory. Yes. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Oh. Yes. 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 Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
When you walk out that door,
yeah.
We may not be beside you.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit is walking with you.
Yes.
Jesus is looking over you as your high priest.
Yes.
Father God, we love you. We gave birth to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Father, for walking that confidence.
Thank you, Jesus.
Today.
It's a new day.
It's the best day in your life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You know that same power that resurrected Christ from the dead now lives in you. You hear me? You hear me, brother? You hear me, brother? I said that same power that was in Christ Jesus, that same power that you confess, that same power that rose him from the dead now lives on the inside of you. So take it, enjoy it. Amen. What's your name? Well, we go with Pepe. You like Pepe. Amen. 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 Well, you got a church home. If you ever need us, come on back. We'll let her have you on Sunday, Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday. Praise God. The church doors are open for you. Amen. All right. All right. We appreciate you, Pepe. This is Pastor Hill here. This is the pastor of the house. Praise God. Well, we ought to be rejoicing. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and continue in the attitude of prayer. Do you have anything, sister, that you would like to exalt us with? All right. All right.
Yes, you can sit right there. Amen.
You know, we was praying. God is so good. And as we was praying, even the scripture where Paul was in, wrote a letter to Timothy. He said, I exalt you, therefore, first of all, supplication and prayer and intercession be made for all saints. For all saints. He said, exalt. This is something that's required that we do, you know. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, this is something that's required. He said, I exalt you. Paul, he had such a burden for the church. He just built up churches. He just went everywhere. And they could throw him in prison. They stoned him and they did all kind of stuff to him. He got up and ran back and said, you thought I was dead. How you like me now? And kept on going, trying to, you know, because that was his heart, was to get the churches going. And he said, I exalt you. That means it ain't just admonishing you. It's like this required of us, saints of God, that we pray. And saints, you know, a lot of times I go to some churches and, you know, and what makes me really go to the churches is the prayer. They over there praying. You know, and I go because they praying. But Paul said, I exalt you. That prayer, that supplication, is petitioning for somebody else. When the last time you petitioned God for somebody else's finances? When the last time you petitioned God, my God, for somebody else's children? When the last time you prayed for God, not for yourself, but prayed for God? Supplication. He said prayer. He said men always have to pray and not faint. Prayer. first of all. He said first of all. He didn't say first of all. First of all, that means not just the most important, but necessity. It's a necessity. It's a necessity that we, my God, supplication be made. We got to make supplications. We got to stand up. Verses, because I'm trying to preach and teach and everything else. Let me just read the verses. And he goes to say, for king, look at that, y'all. Look at that. Look at that. For kings and for all of them that are in authority, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honor. That my, I mean, live, to lead is to live a life. My God, quiet. See, Saddam Hussein, they wasn't having a quiet, peaceful life because they monarchy, the man in authority. I don't care. A lot of people is talking about the president. Oh, he's this and he's that. So what? God said the city, because this is a scripture that said, my God, if you take captive in the city, you pray for that. You pray for that in that city because if it's peace, my God, in the city, you're going to have peace. Come on. And so we got to pray for our president. We can't lock him down. We got to lift him up in prayer. For this, look at this now, y'all. Verse 3 says, for this is good and acceptable in the sight of God. Come on now. In the sight of God. That means in the presence of God. Before we all just come out before God. What I'm saying to you, we're all in the presence of Almighty God. And my God, you know what? I'm pleasing in His sight. I might not be pleasing. By the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. How do we know and do the pleasing and acceptable will of God. Oh my God, this time we have to please, honey. I'm not the brown bag. I ain't brown bag you. I ain't trying to get a brownie point from nobody. I just want to get a brownie point from God. I want the Lord to say, well done, daughter. Well done. I want to stand up big and bold and bad. My God, and not scared what nobody thinks. Because you ain't paying near one of my bills. You ain't sitting in no beauty shop to get my hair done. The only one that helps me is Jesus. And he's the only one I'm trying to please. Glory to God. It's time to tell God, yeah. Yes, God. I do your will. I go. Lord, you know what we need to be effective in this hour. My God, the world is dying around the saints. We people of God. But I see a mighty revival breaking out in Tulsa. I'll speak this thing. I'll speak this thing. And you know what? A mighty revival. I see even different churches coming in here and laying in their faith before prayer. Let's speak this thing into existence. Cry, because that's all we need. We don't need no mic. We just need to cry out. Oh, glory to God. We just need to cry out to God. Get in the corner somewhere and pray to fail. My God, come on here. And if the Holy Ghost has his way, when the Holy Ghost has his way, whoever you want to use, that thing will just issue about him. A little 3-year-old can, my God, begin to give utterance. Come on now. It's time to listen and obey. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all, thank you for listening to me.
Song on your heart?
The one you have that you sing at 5 o'clock prayer will be famous. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hey, Pastor. Okay, I know. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. There's nothing worth more that can ever come close. Nothing can compare. He's our living hope.
Yes.
In your presence, Lord.
Yes.
Your presence, Lord. Yes. It's in your presence, Lord. I tasted and seen of the sweetest of love, where my heart become free and my shame is undone. It's in the presence, Lord.
Hallelujah.
In your presence, Lord. It's in your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill our atmosphere. Your presence, Lord, is what my heart's longed for. To be overcome in your presence, oh Lord. It's in your presence, Lord. In your presence, Lord. In your presence, Lord. In your presence. In your presence. There is joy, joy, joy. In your presence. In your presence. I find so much peace. Let me linger and let me stay in your presence day by day till thy likeness be formed before. Like Jesus, all I want is to be like him, a little more meeker, lowly and holy. All I want is to be like him, just to be like Jesus, just to be like Jesus.
Jesus is the Word. And the Word would never return back to God void. Amen? Hallelujah. So we ought to pray out His what? His Word.
Hallelujah.
His Word ministers on to Him. And when He's ministered on to, His faith is built up. Amen. And He begins to operate by faith, and He will endow you with that which you petition on to Him. Amen. So let's continue to pray His Word. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for those that are in authority in our lives, Lord God. Thank you for those that are in local authority, those that are in state authority, those that are in federal authority, those that are in international authority, Lord God. We pray for them right now. We stand in the gap for them right now, Lord God, lifting them up, Lord, to you, Lord God, that the eyes of their understanding be enlightened, that you endow upon them, Heavenly Father, the spirit of wisdom and the spirit of revelation in the knowledge of you, Lord God. If they don't know you, Heavenly Father, we pray that laborers come across their path, Lord God, that will minister unto them Christ Jesus, that they get born again, set free, filled with the Holy Ghost, Lord God. Oh, thank you, Lord, that we can live a quiet and peaceful life, Lord God, as we continue to lift them up, Lord God. We thank you for the fivefold ministry, Lord God. Those pastors, those apostles, those teachers, those prophets, those evangelists, Lord God, that you'll continue to minister on to them, and they'll continue to minister on to you, Lord God, that they operate under the anointing, Heavenly Father, that destroys yokes, that lifts burdens, Lord God. We thank you for those that are in authority, Heavenly Father, especially in the kingdom, Lord God, that they are operating in the way that you called them to operate, under full manifestation of your glory, Heavenly Father, being evident, being prevalent, Lord God, by power and demonstration. We thank you for your word. We thank you for Jesus, the great one that's on the inside of us. We thank you for the Holy Ghost that leads and guides us in all truth, Lord God. We thank you for all the spiritual blessings that you've endowed us with, Heavenly Father, so that we can go out and do the work of the ministry, Lord God. We covet the ministry gift that you show us, that you continue to show us a more excellent way, Lord God, a supernatural way, a supernatural way. Oh, thank you, Lord God, for our vacation is a supernatural getaway. Our vacation is a supernatural getaway, Lord God. We thank you for healing operating, the gifts of healing, Lord God, operating in our lives, Lord God. We thank you for greater prosperity in our lives, Lord God. Hallelujah. No longer controlled by this worldly system, but controlled by the kingdom of God, operating on our behalf. We thank you that you've made us ambassadors of the kingdom of God, Lord God, and that we operate as so, Lord God, that we are under the jurisdiction of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We thank you the way that you made us in your image and your likeness. We thank you that we look like you. Hallelujah. We thank you that our likeness is just like your likeness. The ability to create and make whatever is necessary, Heavenly Father, for the time and the need, Lord God. Oh, we thank you for the anointing that destroys the yoke and lifts the burden, Lord God. That we're full of the anointing, Lord God. Full of the manifestation of your love, Lord God. That we love you with all our heart. That we love you with all our soul. That we emotionally attached to the will of God. That we love you with our intellect. That we love you with our imagination, Lord God. That we love our neighbor as ourselves. That we continue to mature in your word, Lord God. We continue to mature in love. No longer our relationships based upon conditions, but that we can love our neighbor unconditionally. That we can pray for him unconditionally. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for the greater one on the inside. Thank you for the image and likeness that you made us in. Oh, hallelujah. The image is Christ being in us, being able to speak the word and seeing the Holy Ghost manifested in the earth. Oh, we thank you for that image. We thank you for that likeness to be able to call things into existence, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, we know that the word says that in the beginning was the word. So we speak the word. Anytime we want anything to happen, we can just speak the word. And the Omega, the beginning, the ending of our salvation, Lord God. Oh, we thinking that salvation doesn't start when we die, but salvation starts when we get born again. Meaning we're fully equipped to accomplish your perfect will, God. We have everything that is necessary to accomplish your perfect will. That heaven doesn't start when we die, but heaven starts right now. That we can reign as king and priest in the earth, Lord God. Using full authority. We thank you that we qualify for your authority, Lord God. Your authority to speak the word over every situation and circumstance in our lives, Lord God. Oh, we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. But we're not longer just born of the blood. We're no longer born of the flesh. Oh, hallelujah, but we're born of the will of God. We're born of the will of God. We're born of the will of God. And the word is made flesh. Oh, hallelujah. The word is made flesh, Lord God. And we beheld his glory. The glory is of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace. The fully equipping to accomplish his perfect will. And full of truth. The ability to manifest that which is true, even when the facts dictate something else. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Grace and truth. Grace and truth. Grace and truth. Truth, the ability to manifest anything that is necessary to change a fact that doesn't line up with the word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That we're full of grace, that we're full of truth. Oh, we thank you that the fervent, effectual prayer of a righteous man that it avails much.
Yes.
How many of you know a righteous man is that which standing on the word?
Right.
Standing on the word. Yes. You gotta speak the word in any situation and circumstance. Glory to God. Glory to God. Righteousness is standing on the word. What are you standing on? Are you standing on the word? Are you praying out the word of God? Are you calling those things that are not as though they were, or are you begging for something? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Call those things that are not as though they were. Hallelujah. Concerning your family, concerning your finances, concerning your ailments that are in your body. Oh, thank you, Lord God, for the spirit man that's on the inside. For when I speak the word, the Bible says that it will quicken this mortal body. It will change and affect. Heavenly Father, oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you for the power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost operating in our lives. Oh, how many of you know charity starts at home? Get it for yourself first. Oh, like she said, be not conformed in this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove God's word to be true. Prove it to be true in your own life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then we can petition God that we can effect change in somebody else's life, Lord God. But charity starts at home. Love starts at home. First, he said, love God with all your heart, soul, and mind. This is the first and great commandment. The second is like unto it, to love your neighbor as yourself. Oh, seek God for yourself. Allow God to operate on the inside for yourself. And then you'll be able to deliver to your brother. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the grace, the power that resurrected God from the dead now lives on the inside of us. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you for that yoke destroying, burden lifting power that is just ready to resonate in our lives, Lord God. Ready to be in full demonstration and full display, Heavenly Father, when we walk out our doors in the morning. Glory to you, today. Thank you that we have a church home, pastor. That will teach us the word. Fill us up with the word, Lord God. Fill us up with the word that we take it home, that we are studying, that our cup runneth over. Hallelujah. That it's not just full, but that it runs over, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. That others can lean up against that cup because it's running over and get a little extra. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, we just got to delight in his word. But the Bible says when you delight in his word, he'll give you the desires of your heart. Hallelujah. We just got to start delighting in his word again. Hallelujah. Delighting in his word. I didn't just say read his word. I said delight in his word. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in his word. And again, I say rejoice. In case you didn't get it, he said rejoice in the word. But if you didn't get it the first time, he said it again. I say rejoice in his word. Come the word, that I get my amusement in the word, that I'm no longer entertaining foolishness, but I'm entertaining the word. Hallelujah. And it's in full operation in my life. Glory to your name, Lord God. Glory to your name, Lord God. Glory to your name, Lord God, for a new day, a greater day, a new day, a greater day, a new day, a greater day where the anointing is flowing, because I have the knowledge of him, because I'm endowed with the spirit of wisdom and revelation, that I know exactly what God would have me to do, because I have the hope of his calling. I have the riches which is in glory, which is my inheritance. I'm taking back what the enemy took from me. My ministry is stopped. Hallelujah. Yeah, the greater one that's on the inside of me is in full operation, far above all principality, far above all powers. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Oh, thank you that Jesus, the Word, Jesus, the Word, everything is under his feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I thank you. I pray that out, Lord God. Oh, that you continue to give me the spirit of wisdom and revelation, that that the eyes of my understanding be enlightened, that I may know your word. No longer guessing, no longer shooting, but hitting the mark right on every single time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we just thank you for your word. We thank you for all those that you called to come out and pray your word today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, we just thank you, Lord. We thank you for this opportunity to come before you, the throne room. Oh, hallelujah. In prayer. We thank you for Pastor. Who was obedient. Obedient to allow us to come and pray out the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we're going to turn it back over to Pastor. Yeah, what Pastor told me to turn it over to Pastor. So I'm going to be obedient. Amen. So I'm going to turn it back
over. You know, this month was the national, we had a national day of prayer this month. You also know that during the teacher's walkout, you know, they fought tooth and nail trying to get a raise and funding for our schools. Well, while that was going on, one of our lawmakers introduced a bill, and this bill passed through the House and the Senate in no time, and it ended up on the governor's desk along with the bill that was wrote up the school funding and the pay raises. Well, this bill, on that National Day of Prayer, my sole purpose was to pray that she didn't sign that particular bill. And I'm gonna tell you why. This lawmaker introduced this bill, and this bill was designed to put weapons in anyone's hand without a permit.
Yeah.
As long as you were 21, I guess it didn't have any felonies. But if you were in the service, you could be 18 and carry open carry without a permit. Well, I prayed. I spent the entire time that we were here on that day of prayer and prayed that God would stay our hand and not let her sign the bill, harden. But as of today, she has not signed that bill into law.
Amen.
So prayer is very, very powerful and important. When your heart is in the right place, when you're praying for the right reasons, God will hear you and listen to you and honor your prayer. So I thank God for hearing not just me, all everybody else that prayed that you wouldn't sign that law into bill. Because it would have been devastating to our neighborhoods, to our streets, to our churches, just everywhere. It would have been devastating. So I thank God that he kept her and stayed in her hand, that she did not sign that bill into law. And that's, I just want to share that with you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I think when we come together, we need to share a scripture and read the word. Amen. But I, first of all, I want to thank everyone for your prayers for me. Your prayers are prevailing much. Amen. And I thank God that I am doing much better in my body and mainly in my soul. Amen. I've been through some things, but I thank God I'm still here. Amen. And with the determination to go on and fulfill the will of God. I just have several books I want to recommend and about four scriptures and I'll be finished. I want to obey God as well. Along with our pastor's book, Prevailing Prayer, which is awesome. I also have just recently, some of these books I've had for years, I've had Prayers That Avail It Much by Jermaine Copeland. That's always been a part of my library. But recently, and this one is an old one, A Global Call to Prayer by Jermaine Copeland. I want to encourage you to get that as a part of your library. And recently she's come out with this one, Prayers That Avail Much for the Nations. I remember I used to go through the globe, so to speak, world map, thank you, Lord, and just pray for different nations. I tell you, that season in my life was just a good time for me in learning and growing. But I'm so thankful she put this book out, Prayers That Avail Much for the Nations. And it will help you learn just little small places that we never hear of. But they need our prayers, amen? And then Prayers That Avail Much for America. I just recently got this one. I'm not sure if they're in the bookstore. I ordered them from their website. But I don't know about you, but there are some times when I just want to just be in the presence of the Lord and pray softly, not always loud and running, but to sit down and read these prayers and then pray in the spirit and then go through the scriptures has really been a wonderful process in my life, and I want to encourage you to do the same. The one scripture I want to share with us, if I can get a reader right quick, Psalm 32:6. And want to encourage you that everything is birth, sustain, and fulfill through prayer. Amen. Our ministries, our walk with Christ, amen. It has to come through prayer. And just a brief word of encouragement. Psalm 32:6 says what?
For this shall.
Keep reading, both can read now.
For this cause, everyone who is godly shall pray to you in a time when you may be found.
Yes.
Surely in a flood of great waters, they shall not come near him. You are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from trouble.
Yeah.
You shall surround me with songs of deliverance.
Thank you, Jesus.
Selah,
which means stop and think about it.
All right.
Hey, you are my hiding place. But it starts out, let everyone that is godly do what? Pray. Any godly people in here? Any people of God? He says, pray. In the time of great waters, that can represent troubles. That can represent problems. But even during that time, we have to do what?
Pray.
For he will sustain us. He will keep us. He is our hiding place. And I want to encourage myself, you can listen in while I encourage myself, to continue to pray and not faint.
Yes.
Amen. And not give up. Glory to God. James 5:13.
It's the next one. Amen. Want to encourage you. I tell you, I had to call intercessors. Pray for me. Because I experienced some things that looked like it wanted to just take me into deep depression. But I called for the intercessors. Amen. They began to pray for me. So in the time of trouble, we should always pray. James 5:13 says what?
Is anyone among you suffering?
Anyone suffering? Anyone going through?
Let him pray.
Let him do what?
Pray.
Let him pray. Amen. Experiencing trials, experiencing difficulties. Let him pray. We don't get our towel and say, I surrender, give up. Only surrender we give is to the Lord. Amen. I surrender to the Lord. Amen. I surrender your will. My will to your will. My mind to your mind. Everything that pertains to godliness, I surrender to you, Jesus. But we don't give up. Amen. Keep reading.
Is anyone cheerful?
Uh-huh.
Let him sing.
Let him sing songs. I like the last song that says songs of deliverance.
Is anyone among you sick?
Mm-hmm.
Let him call for the elders of the church.
Amen. You're afflicted. You're going through. You have a negative doctor's report. Go ahead and call for those. Amen. Amen. Who are strong in the Lord, who are strong in the word of prayer. And the prayer of faith will what? Save the sick. If you've done any sin, the Lord will do what? Forgive. Amen. That's the word. Somebody say that's the word.
That's the word.
Colossians 4:2 is the next one. Amen. When we're talking about elders, it doesn't necessarily mean age as much as it means maturity spiritually. Amen. Someone who's strong in faith. Colossians 4:2 says,
continue earnestly in prayer,
mm-hmm.
being vigilant in it with thanksgiving.
Continue in prayer. Mine says devote yourself to pray. Amen. Not just here in corporate prayer, but individually. Let's devote ourselves to prayer. Let's have that prayer life. Amen. Amen. Let's have that one-on-one where it's you and the Lord. Amen. Devote yourself. Continue in prayer. Commit yourself to prayer. My last one, 1 Thessalonians 5:17. 1 Thessalonians 5:17.
Pray without ceasing.
Uh-huh. Continuously. Let it be as easy as the breath you breathe. Amen.
In everything give thanks,
mm-hmm.
for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you.
For you. Yes. Give thanks. Be thankful. Amen. Because whatever you're experiencing, we know that God will bring us through. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Pray continuously. And then three things happen when we pray. Lives and circumstances change. Yes. Yes. Prayer does change things.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Then God's presence is shown, brought out even earlier, being in the presence of the Lord. And his presence is fullness of joy. At his right hand is what? Pleasures forevermore. Glory to God. That's Jesus on the right hand, ever living to make intercession for us. And it's nothing like experiencing the presence of the Lord. Now, I love corporate prayer. But it's nothing like that personal time with the Lord, and you're talking to him and you're crying out to him. I'm talking about your private time with the Lord. There's nothing like his presence coming in and touching you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And tears begin to flow, and you know you're in a different atmosphere. You know that he stepped into the room. It's nothing like his presence. So prayer, glory to God, causes his presence to show up. And then the third thing that blesses us when we pray is we get guidance.
Yes. Yes.
How many need guidance today?
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We
don't want to make a decision. We don't even want to go to the store without his guidance. We might have our to-do list.
Yes. Amen.
But we want his guidance. Amen. The way things are happening, world, even in Oklahoma City yesterday, I think it was yesterday. People in a restaurant enjoying themselves or with their families. And this person didn't even come in. He shot through the window. Come on. We want God's guidance. Thank you, Jesus. How many know the day we're living in now, the scriptures are becoming more and more real. We're seeing the scriptures being fulfilled. Trust in the Lord with what? All your heart. Lean not to what? Your own understanding, but in all your ways. All your ways. Do what? Acknowledge him and he'll direct our path. The Holy Spirit might tell you don't go to that one or don't go that way. Hallelujah. He has a plan. And we only want what he wants for us. How many love him today?
Hallelujah.
How many love him today? Shout to the Lord with the voice of triumph. For he has given us the victory. Hallelujah. Oh God, we thank you today. We praise you for your word. It's a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. We thank you for your word. Heaven and earth will pass away, but your word will still remain. Your word is true. And we thank you, God, that your word is a solid rock. Woo, glory to God. On Christ, a solid rock. The word we stand. Hallelujah, God. We want our trust in you and you alone. And we thank you, Father. You have proven yourself to be who you are. We bless you. We thank you. We bless you for blessing us. Come on, somebody. We love you because you first loved us. You have taught us how to love. And we thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. Father God, we thank you for your presence. Somebody show them some love right now. I tell you, praise the name of God. Hallelujah. I tell you, the word is so important. It's fulfilling. The deception is on an all-time high. Deceivers and false teachers have been released, but we thank God for his word. That's true. You don't have to leave. I'm through.
See, there's a song for your prescription,
almost.
Yes, it
is. God bless you, Pastor. Thank you, Jesus. You are my hiding place. You are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from troubles, and you shall compass me about with songs of deliverance. What time I am
Brother, how you end up here this morning? How you get here? Oh. All right. All right. Praise God. All right. This is our preacher over here. Praying preacher. Amen. Praying preacher. Glory. She's a real blessing to us in our morning sessions. All right. Everybody standing. Father, we thank you for the ability to sow a seed and targeting the blessing that we are seeking. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name today, we thank you for the spirit of prayer. We thank you for our leader and the woman of faith and woman of great blessings to others, and that have pioneered the school of the prayer school for many years. We thank you, God, that you who begun the work in her, you are still honoring your word. Father, we thank you today for grace and her healing and her completeness and wholeness from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Lord, we are still complete in you. And Lord, we thank you that prayer not only changes things, but prayer changes people. And people can change things. Father, we thank you for victory and deliverance. We give you praise and glory now in Jesus' name. Everybody say in Jesus' name. Amen. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy, to the only wise God be glory, honor, dominion, and power both now and forever. Everybody say amen. 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 All right.
You are my hiding place.
Yes, Lord.
You shall preserve me,
yes,
from troubles, and you shall compass me about with songs of deliverance.
Yes,
what time I
oh,